One of the confusions with patellar tendon rehab is what do you do when there's pain in exercise? What if things hurt the patellar tendon? What if in the weight room, leg extensions cause pain? What if squats cause pain? What if split squats cause pain? On the field or the court, what if acceleration hurts? What if change of direction hurts? What if jumping hurts? What if the actual sport itself causes pain in the patellar tendon? Often athletes have such bad pain, they just rest and they ice. And this is bad for the structure of the patellar tendon, and it's bad for the function of the patellar tendon. If you've read this study, patellar tendinopathy, clinical diagnosis, load management, and advice for challenging case presentations, they cover this exact question. What do we do when there is pain in exercise? The paper says, as tendon pain is intimately linked with load, the authors describe the response to the test as load tolerance. If the pain score on the load test, which is the single leg decline squat, has returned to the baseline within 24 hours of the activity or rehabilitation session, the load has been tolerated. If the pain is worse, load tolerance has been exceeded. It is the author's opinion that pain assessment based on a standard load test for each individual is more important than a pain rating during exercise to determine the progression of loading through the course of the rehabilitation. So what they're saying is pain 24 hours later matters more than pain during the session. But if you're worried about pain during the session, pain of 3 to 5 out of 10 is acceptable. So if you experience pain with something like a single leg extension in the weight room, isometric, it doesn't really matter. It only matters if the pain is excruciating. You want to avoid excruciating pain. But something like this, a sissy squat, this can cause a lot of pain, but it doesn't matter as long as it's not excruciating. What does matter is the next day's pain response. You'll always know the next day. The tendon will tell you by being more painful whether it responded good or bad to the training loads. It's unlikely that isometrics or isotonics are going to flare up your tendon the next day, but when you get back into the store and release, the jumping activities, when the tendon has to store and release, when it has to act like a spring, these are going to be more painful during, and they are more likely to provoke pain the next day. But we do not care about pain during as long as it's not excruciating. If you listen to my podcast with Jason Yore, he actually likes to push people into pain because they can become so fearful of their tendon always needing to feel good. So don't be afraid of pain. Be concerned if there's more pain the next day.